Alright, so now we are understanding the concept of spanning tree protocol. Basically, what does spanning tree protocol do? Spanning tree protocol prevents switching loops. Switching loops. What are switching loops? Switching loops are those loops which are created by your layer 2 switch. Okay, the broadcasts which are forwarded on the layer 2. That means whatever the broadcasts are being forwarded by this switch or this switch, so it prevents if the loop is there. So this is a loop. If you see, this is a circular loop. So if the broadcast keeps on moving, so it forms a broadcast loop. It eats up your bandwidth. Basically, what does spanning tree protocol does is, spanning tree protocol blocks one of your site so that it only flows in one direction. It doesn't come out of here, so that means your loop is not formed. It doesn't form a closed loop. If you see this diagram, this is logical. This blocking is logical. So at the end, your diagram would end up like this. Is it forming a loop? No. Okay. So now we're gonna, now in our devices over here, I have configured switch 1, switch 2, and switch 3. So I'm not gonna show you how we do that, how we enable and see the spanning tree. Now if you see over here, in this, if you see, we are now seeing the spanning tree, now we are seeing the spanning tree for VLAN 1, okay, for VLAN 1. In this, right now the priority is 32769, but actually it should be 32768. If you see over here, the priority is mentioned at 32768. What is the one extra in that? That is called as system extended IP. What it does is, the VLAN number, whatever the VLAN number you know, that is included into the priority. Okay, so what happens when it sends, okay, when this priority is sent to other switch, when this priority number in the BPDU is sent to the other switch, okay, there, if it knows that it should be 32768 only, it should be in the multiples of 4096. Okay, it should be in the multiples of 4096. So if it's a multiple of 4096, it will be 32768. What is the one extra in that? So it will come to know that it is for VLAN 1. Similarly, right now we have only one VLAN configured. If you do, let's say we have created a VLAN 2. Now if you do show spanning tree for VLAN 2, you see, it is 32770. It increments, not increment, but now it is for VLAN 2. That means 32768 is my priority, and this extended ID represents as my VLAN number. Let's take another VLAN. Now you see, 32768 is my priority, and extended ID is 100. So the other switch within the BPDU will come to know that, okay, the system extended ID is 100, so that means this is the priority for VLAN 100. Now if you see, here it is in blocking mode. One of the ports, FA01 of switch 1, if you see our diagram, in the diagram, switch 1, our one port is in blocking port, okay, and the other is in listening, that means it is listening up. It is listening up all the MAC addresses. Alright? Now let's see for switch 2. here also for VLAN 1 only. Now in this, both are the ports in forwarding. Both the ports are in forwarding. And the cost is 19, but this is not the root bridge because it doesn't have the least MAC address. Finally, let's see for switch 3. This bridge is the root. If you see that, it shows that this bridge is the root. That means my switch 3 is my bridge, root bridge.
Yeah.
Okay? And that it has the lowest MAC address because all of them have the same priority. Okay? And both of the ports, if you see, both of the ports of the root bridge are in designated mode.
Yeah.
Alright? And you see here the port priorities. The port priorities are 128 by default, which is 128 by default. It's a port, yeah. Okay.
19 is fast Ethernet.
19 is the cost of fast Ethernet. This is the cost you see over here.
Yeah.
The cost is separate. Cost is 19 of fast Ethernet, but the priority, let it be a gigabit Ethernet or let it be a fast Ethernet. The ports, the port priority for both of them is 128. Alright? And